It's Attorney Bose. You know, I like to go out at night, and sometimes I want to be able to see in the distance. Now, this may be something that is irregular in the binocular world. I don't know. I haven't been a part of it long enough to know that answer. And although I am now into thermals and night vision, the tried and true binocular set that you've got with you may be something that you can use way into the evening time. Not for hunting, I understand, but for other observations that need to be made at night. Why not pick up a pair of binos that you can multitask with? Use them during the day for your hunt. Use them during the day for your other activities, your bird watching, your people watching and whatnot. But also have that set available to you at night to make relevant observations without it being completely useless during the nighttime. So in setting out for finding a pair of binos that I can carry with me at all times, that serve me during the night, was the focus of this particular video and this endeavor. Now, tradition has it that in looking at binos and optics that perform well during the evening time, you're looking at something that has at least a 50 millimeter objective lens. This is the Konus 12x50 unit. This is the Konusrex unit. I've talked about this unit in various tests. It's a nice pair of binoculars. It's got a little bit of weight to it, not as much as the Athlon 12x50s in Midas series, but it's got some weight to it. You will know that you're carrying this around. But the issue that I brought this out here for is the 50 millimeter objective lens and the 12 power and the silver coating, which is what this Konusrex is known for. A silver coating on the lens, multi-coated of course, but with silver, making light transmission second to none in this magnification and objective lens category. 12x50 Konusrex. You would think that this is going to do well during the nighttime, especially having that silver to allow the light transmission. Supposedly these have been advertised at 99% light transmittance. Now, along with that, we're going to be talking about these. Now, this is a Konus Tornado. This is a 7x50, 7 magnification, 50 millimeter objective lens. This is a traditional marine unit. Now, you and I both know that marine units are known for having high light transmission and for use during sunset and early morning hours. So we brought this out to compare this along with the Konusrex as to how they do during true nighttime when you have very little light to work with. Now, the last thing that we're going to be comparing in this little test of ours, and this is not a scientific test, people. I am not an optical enthusiast. I'm just a person that wants to carry binoculars, one set with me, and have it be doing tasks that are across the board and across time span so that I don't have to change out equipment and bring along a bunch of stuff on vacation and other times when I'm out in the field, or if I'm taking a hike and I've only got one set with me, I want that set to perform during my hike, and if my wife and I head out during the evening time, perform then as well. So that last part, the last unit that we're going to be testing, is this little unit. Now, I haven't done a full video on this unit yet, but this deserves your second look. Maybe it's your first look. This is the Athlon Little Pocket Midas UHD in 10x25. This is a powerhouse, people. This folds like you wouldn't believe, and it weighs a mere 8 ounces. This is a powerhouse. I just came back from a hike from Potomac Overlook to the mouth of the Pimmit Run. I was carrying along this unit, didn't even know that it was around my neck half the time. And I had both the case as well as the unit with me attached separately so that I never drop this unit. This Athlon, yeah, it's Chinese made, but let me tell you, this is a beauty. This Athlon produces some of the sharpest, clearest images, punching way past its 10x25 objective lens. Look at these objective lens. They are absolutely tiny in comparison to this Konusrex 12x50. I mean, seriously, which one of these would you carry along with you if you were going on a hike? This thing weighs a minimum of, I would say, around 21, 22, maybe 23 ounces. This is 8 ounces, 8.5 ounces, okay? Just the de minimis real estate that you are carrying, but the ability to pop it out, because it's double hinged, pop it out and get your visual and have it be absolutely crystal clear, edge to edge. I've never seen anything like it. But let's test it out with against these two units with 50 millimeter objective lens, because that's what most people believe. They believe that if you want to use your binoculars during the nighttime, you should have a minimum of 50 millimeters objective lens to let in more of the light. And the metaphor that they use is the window. You want the larger window to let in more light. Smaller window lets in less light. So what you want is the bigger window and the 50 millimeter and above objective lens. Now, there are various factors, I can tell you, that play a role in how much light your particular binocular is going to be letting in to your eyes. And some of that has to do with the coatings that are on it, and some of it has to do with the engineering behind it, and the fine tuning of the prisms that are used in these various units. But let's go ahead and just stop talking and get a visual. Okay, I'm going to be trying to view something which is out in the distance that is obviously dark because it's now nighttime, and there's very little lighting from these little traffic lights that are up here, but let's see what we can see. Okay. Yeah, I can tell you that these Konusrexes with that silver coating and the 50 millimeter lens, although it's somewhat dark, I can still make out in the tree line, the shadows that are being produced by the traffic light on the tree line, I can still make out a very good sight picture of what's happening. And if there was someone or something within that tree line, I can tell you I would have no problem knowing that something was there, and if it's movement, I would definitely be able to tell whether it was a animal or a human. If it was a four-legged animal, I would probably have a little bit of pause trying to identify exactly what that four-legged animal was, but I would venture to say that knowing whether something is out here or not would not be a problem in the least. And that's the Konusrex 12x50 by Konus. Silver coated objective lens, actually silver coated all the way around, if I understand from their material. So let's go over to this Tornado. Now, like I said, this is for marine use, right? It's got less magnification. This is only 7 magnification. It's a 7x50 unit, but it's got that large objective lens on here. Let's take a look. Okay, this does not have the silver coating on it. And this is obviously individualized focus, meaning each one of these barrels have been set and focused to my eyes. So there is no focusing wheel on the top of this unit. I have seen more detail and slightly better sight picture with these, I gotta tell you. That silver coating on these is amazing. But in the dark, along the tree line, again, I would really have no problem making out any type of movement. And if positioned just correctly, if the thing that you are targeting is positioned just correctly, I could probably make out exactly what type of animal it was. It would take a little bit of patience and a little bit of time making that observation, but I think I would be able to do it. Now, let's get to this unit. This little 25 millimeter objective lens unit. You would think that these would not perform at all or be able to perform at all just based on the de minimis objective lens that's on here. Most pocket units are deplorable during the nighttime because they allow so little light into the objective lens and producing a visual for you that it's just not even worth it bringing it out at nighttime at all. Not with these Athlons. That is simply amazing. That sight picture, even at nighttime, people, I'm getting more light in this unit than I did on this marine unit. I'm getting a clear, crisp picture. I can focus in on the tree line. I can focus in on a particular tree. I have no problem making out anything along this tree line at all. I can make out all of the individual bushes and the smaller trees versus the larger trees. That's just amazing. I'm going to compare these two head to head because this one produced a very fine picture in the darkness. Let me just see whether they are on par or not. Okay. That I can tell you this, this is the clear winner as far as night, being able to see during the nighttime. This is definitely the clear winner, but this little handheld pocketable unit, it's up there. This is definitely, because of its coating and its ED glass, this Athlon UHD Midas 10 by 25 unit is almost on par with this Konusrex 12 by 50 unit as far as clarity of your visual during nighttime. And that's saying a lot.